In this video, we will solve a problem from the 2023 AMC 12A mass computation. The question is, what is the value of this expression? So we can use two methods to solve this question. So let's see the first method. So let's start from this expression. 2 cubed minus 1 cubed plus 4 cubed minus 3 cubed plus 6 cubed minus 5 cubed and so on up to 18 cubed minus 17 cubed. So first we can rewrite the expression. So we're going to separate the positive terms and the negative terms like this. Positive term first. Next. So the next. Then up to here. Then for negative terms, this is the first one. Then here. Next one. Then up to this one. 17 cubed. So next, let's write down this part again. In here, the first term, the second term, then the last term. Since for the second part, we don't only have cubes of all numbers, but also we want to have cubes of even numbers here. So now let's just write this way. So then here just negative 1 cubed, then minus 2 cubed, then minus 3 cubed, minus 4 cubed, and so on. Then up to the last one, so 18 cubed. Since here we minus the cubes of even numbers to balance out this action, so now we need to double this sum. So here we're going to put just times 2. So now let's see here. Since 2, 4, 18, they are even numbers. So they have common factor 2. So then for 2, we can put as 2 times 1. Then 4 is like 2 times 2. Then here, then this one is like 2 times 9. So since we have cube here, so they have common factor 2 cubed. So let's take out the common factor for the first part. So then here, 2 times 2 cubed. So then the inside part just 1 cubed. Then here, 2 cubed. And so on. The last one is 9 cubed. Then for the second part, let's take out the negative sign. Then here, the inside, 1 cubed plus 2 cubed. Then up to 18 cubed. So then for this part and this part, we can use the following formula. The sum of the first n cubed. So then this is the formula. So 1 to the third plus 2 to the third, then up to n to the third, then just equals here, this is the formula, then just equals n times n plus 1, then divided by 2, then whole thing squared. So now let's apply this formula to the first part. So then here, so n is 9. Let's continue with this equal sign. Then here, just here's a 16. Then use the formula, n is 9. So then here's 9 times 9 plus 1, then divided by 2, then squared, then minus. So then for the second part, also apply this formula. So here, n is 18. Then here, just 18 times 18 plus 1, then divided by 2, then squared. Then simplify the inside part. Then here, for 16, we can put as 4 squared. So then here, the inside part is 9 times 5, then squared. Then for this part simplified, so that's just 9 times 19, then squared. Since they have common factor 9 squared, so take out the common factor, 9 squared. So then 4 squared and 5 squared, so that's 20 squared. Then minus 19 squared. Then factor the inside part. So here's 81 and 20 minus 19 and 20 plus 19. And here just 81 times 1. Then here 39. Then just equals 3,159. So that is the first method. So now let's see the second method. So again, let's start from the question. So that's 2 to the third minus 1 to the third, then 4 to the third minus 3 to the third, and so on up to then 18 to the third minus 17 to the third. So this time we're going to treat each difference as a group. So we're going to group these two together. Then these two together. So now we have 9 groups. So next we're going to write the sum of the 9 groups use a sigma notation. Then here, just the sigma. So k from 1 to 9, since we have 9 groups. Since this one's even number, see, the even number. So here, we're going to put a 2k, then to the third, then minus. Since this one, just all numbers, then here's a 1 number less than here. So then this one is a 2k minus 1, then to the third. So you see here, so 1k is 1, put here, so then this is a 2. So then this is this term. Then here, 1k is 1, this is a 2 minus 1, the first term. Then 1k is 9, you see, 9, 2 times 9 is 18, this one. So then 18 minus 1 is 17. Okay, so then this is a sigma notation just for this sum. So now let's expand this part. And that's the first term, 2k to the third. So then it's a binomial formula to expand this part. So then here, the first one is a 2k to the third minus 3 times 2k squared. Then plus 3 times 2k, then minus 1. Next, let's distribute the negative sign to each of them. So then here, so the first term and second term just cancel out since they are exactly the same. So next, then just 12 k squared, then minus 6k, then plus 1. So now let's separate the one sum into three sums. So then the first one here, then 12 times the sigma k from 1 to 9, then k squared. Then the second term, minus 6 times the sigma, then k from 1 to 9. Then here is k. Then the last one, just a sigma. Then here just constant 1. So then for this part, so we can use a formula, the sum of the first n squares. So then this is a formula. So here, just sum, so k from 1 to n. So k squared just equals, then here n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1, then divided by 6. So that's for the first part. So now let's see here. So this is just a sum of the first n terms. So then here, this is the second formula, k from 1 to n. So k. So then just equals then n times n plus 1 divided by 2. So now let's continue with this equal sign. For the first part, this one, use this formula. So here, so n is 9. So then the first part, so 12, again use the formula, n is 9, so then here just 9 times 9 plus 1, then here 2 times 9 plus 1, then divided by 6. Then for the second part, apply this formula, so then here minus 6, then n is 9. So here's 9 times 9 plus 1, then divided by 2. Then for the last sum, just plus 9. Okay, so then simplify this part. So 6 and 12 canceled. So here is 2 times 9, then times 10, then times this one is 19. So 2 and 6 canceled, so then here just 3 times 9 times 10, then plus 9. So then the calculate the whole thing, so then we have the answer is 3,159. So that is the answer for this question. Thanks for watching.